Olympic is my dream. I say I want to represent the country for my friends laugh at me. I say, oh, how can this sport be very tough? You know? I say, I'll prove to you. We always say that if this person can, so can I. Eh? But you cannot just use your mouth. You must work for it. Only train. That's my life, you know? For 10 years, I was doing it. I won my first national open championship. That was at the age of 19. I was selected for Olympic Games. This was my peak, yeah? Very high, at the highest. And I was really well prepared. I do sparring with all heavyweight guys. So, and people saw that I can take and can punch the heavier guys. My weight category, you know, from other countries, they're quite worried that they want to spar with me. And when we went to Munich, I was confident. So the next match against Cuba, I myself know that I'll win. But in the second round, he came with a head. Very small, very small cut. So referee stopped the fight. Doctor came up, checked, and this my corner man just wipe and dab it, and the blood stops. A very small cut. No, we can continue. So anyway, what to do? I cannot do anything. They don't allow me to fight. I cried. You know, I cannot do anything. Although I went to the Olympic Games, 71 SEAP Games was the best fight now for me because the final opponent was a Burmese. He was purposely brought down from the hill tribe for purpose of boxing. And he was fearsome, very fierce guy, you know. And he was the number one in Asia at that time. The coach of that Burmese is very arrogant. When we met in the dining hall, he came to me, he says, you're meeting my boy, you know? You eat more. He told me to eat more. You know? I thought he was serious. Okay, I say, I'll see you tonight, that's all. Okay. Then when I beat this boy, I would say that I shook the world. You know, Singapore, they don't know. Singapore has got boxers who can win. I don't know what is retire. Not in my vocab.
Mr. Kadir is very driven, he's passionate. The day I wanted to quit, Coach Kadir actually approached me and asked me if I want to go for a fight. So I went for the match. What happened was that my corner stopped the fight in the first round because Coach Kadir decided to throw in the towel. And I remember that I was devastated, went to the toilet, hide, cried like a girl, come back. Then Coach Kadir approached me and he said, don't cry, don't give up on yourself. It's my decision to quit, it's not your choice. I treat you like my son, so it's my job to protect you. And upon hearing that, I decided he's a man with a big heart and I wanted to stay in the sport, and that's why I'm still here today.
As people say, any sports lover, you're involved, you have to sacrifice the time, you know, and your youth. As long as I'm still strong, I will continue to help the young kids. The kids, they need guidance. And I feel that if I don't give back what I enjoy from the sports, I feel that I'm not doing the right thing.